Welcome, Kingdom Fun. Happy Sunday. I'm Miss Donicka. The title of today's lesson is Parable of the Wise and Foolish Builder. Let's get started. Our scripture readings come from the book of Matthew, chapter 7, verses 24 through 29. Our Bible memory verse comes from Hebrews, chapter 11, verses 1 and 6. The focus today is Jesus wants to put his teachings into practice. Wise or foolish? We're going to play a game. If you land on a space that is wise, you are okay. You're just going to stay there. If you land on a space that is foolish, you have to go back one space. Here's our spinner. I'm going to spin the spinner 6 times for me and then 6 times for you. Then we'll use those numbers to play the game. Let's go. That's one for me. 2. 2 again. 2 again. 1. And 1. So those are my 6 turns. Now, here's your 6 turns. You got a 1, a 2, another 2. That's a 3. A 3. And another 3. So there's your 6 turns. Let's go back to the game. Here's our game board. We have 2 game pieces, red for me and blue for you. And here are our spins. Let's take a look at the chart. On our first 3 spins, we both spun the same number. So that means we'll be on the same spots. So let's move our first 3 turns together. Here we are at the start. Our first spin is number 1. If we move one space, it says, say your prayers. Is that a wise choice or a foolish choice? Definitely a wise choice. Next, we spun 2. Let's move. One, 2. Free space. We're good. Now we spun another 2. 1, 2. It says, be selfish. Oh no, that is not a wise choice. Let's go back. We have to go back to share. Wise choice. Now it's my turn by myself. I spun a 2. That would be 1, 2. Free space. Next, you spun a 3. 1, 2, 3. You landed on tell the truth. Is that a wise choice or is that a foolish choice? I hope you guys said wise choice. It's always wise to tell the truth. My turn. 1. Together again, I'm telling the truth too. Wise choice. Next, You spun another three. One, two, three. That's another free space. And I spun a one. Next, three for you. One, two, three. Uh-oh, it says fight with your friends. Is that a wise choice or is that a foolish choice? Definitely a foolish choice. Go back one and obey your parents. Wise choice. Well, that's all our spins. Let's go back to the spinner. Now we're back to the spinner. I'm going to spin four more times to finish up the game. This time, I'm going to start with your four spins. Three. Uh-oh. Three again. Two. And two. So you spun a 3-3-2-2. My turn now. I spun a 3, a 1, a 2, and a 2. Okay. So my four spins are 3-1-2-2. Back to the game board. Now, let's get back to the game. I've updated the chart with our new spins. It's my turn. And I spun a 3. 1, 2, 3. Be kind. Is that a wise choice or a foolish choice? That's a wise choice. Your turn, 3. 1, 2, 3. Be a good friend. Is that a wise choice or a foolish choice? Definitely a wise choice. Oh, you're super close. My turn. 1. Obey your parents. That's a wise choice. Now your turn. 3. 1, 2, 3. Oh, congratulations. You guys won the game. Awesome. Remember, it's important to always think about our choices and make wise decisions. The focus of today's Bible reading is Jesus wants to put his teachings into practice. The Bible story comes from Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 through 29. Here's our Bible timeline. Jesus frequently taught people about God. One of those times was what we call the Sermon on the Mount. Parts of that sermon were the Beatitudes and the Lord's Prayer. This is where we pick up God's story. The wise and the foolish builders. Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. And it fell with a great crash. When Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were amazed at his teaching because he taught as one who had authority and not as their teachers of law. This was one of Jesus's parables. What's a parable? A parable is a story that has a deeper meaning, a story that helps people think about things in a new or different way. Let's think about what went on in this parable. The storms represent hard times. Jesus said that everyone will have hard times in their life. What might be some hard times we might experience? We may get sick, lose a job, our friends might move away, someone's death, even facing temptations. When hard times come, we have a choice to make. We can put Jesus's teachings into practice or don't put them into practice. If we're wise, we'll put his teachings into practice. And that will be like the wise man who built his house on the strong foundation of the rock. Who's our rock? Jesus is our rock. Now let's do some acting. Choose to be the wise builder or the foolish builder. I'm going to play you something, and I want you to pretend you are the house, not the builder, but the house. Okay, class, listen up carefully because I want you to act out what happened to these houses.
Therefore, everyone who hears these words of mine and puts them into practice is like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house. Yet it did not fall, because it had its foundation on the rock. But everyone who hears these words of mine and does not put them into practice is like a foolish man who built his house on sand. The rain came down, the streams rose, and the winds blew and beat against that house, and it fell with a great crash.
Now, which house is still standing? The wise man who built his house on the rock. I don't want to be like the house that crashed. Do you? I want to be like the house that stood strong. I hope you do too. Jesus wants us to have a strong foundation and stand strong when hard times come. That's why Jesus wants us to put his teachings into practice. He knows that when we follow his teachings, we will stand strong. Our Bible memory verse comes from the book of Hebrews, chapter 11, verses 1 and 6. Now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. And without faith, it is impossible to please God, because anyone who comes to him must believe that he exists and that he rewards those who earnestly seek him. According to verse 1, what is faith? Confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. What is impossible to do without faith? You can't please God. When a person comes to God, what must he believe? You must believe that God exists and that he rewards those who seek him. We have faith in a lot of different things. When we have faith in God, we'll always be wise and put Jesus's teachings into practice. Review activities. This week, there are 3 review activities. First, in Wise or Foolish, read Matthew 7, verses 24 through 29 again. Then decide whether each line tells something about the wise or the foolish builder. And in 2 builders, circle the words from the Bible story. Next, we have the 2 houses. Circle the correct words in each sentence. Last, in Choose a Challenge, choose at least 1 of these things you will put into practice, and then write on the lines what exactly you will do. Be as specific as possible. Go to www.nearpod.com to complete our review activities. Our class code is A3WJT. I repeat, our class code is A3WJT. One teaching of Jesus that we can put into practice right now is prayer. Jesus taught a lot about prayer, and Jesus regularly talked to his Father. Right now, let's stand together strong in prayer. Dear God, thank you for the Bible that tells us what Jesus taught. Help us to follow through on our plans of putting Jesus's teaching into practice. God, please help us to love our enemies. Help us to give to those in need. Help us to pray. Help us to use our money for what's really important. Help us to remember that you care about us. And help us to remember not to worry, but trust in you. All these things we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Remember, we love you in Kingdom Fun. Have a blessed week. Bye.